So I'm super excited for today's video because it has to do with food again. So I'm gonna be showing you what I keep in my fridge and pantry here. So kind of like a little tour for you guys. So I'm super excited about this just because I love showing people my food and everything. With that being said, let's go ahead and get into this video. Okay, so the first thing that I'm gonna show you up here is this like fruit basket that I keep right here and all of my spices. So in here I have some lemons, mangoes, sweet potatoes, avocados, there's an apple back there, and then a tomato. Usually I do have like nectarines in here as well. It's really just whatever fruit I find at the grocery store that's in season or is pretty ripe, then I'll grab that. I also just have bananas right here that I always keep on stock. And then right here I have some everything but the bagel seasoning, cinnamon, ginger, turmeric, and what is it? Paprika, which I'm obsessed with. Okay, so this is my fridge. I just have like a standard smaller fridge. It's actually a little bit bigger than like a standard college one. So in here, I just have some bell pepper. This is some sugar-free teriyaki marinade. Sometimes I'll put that on some tofu and marinate it. And then I just have some carrots right here. This is just a half of an avocado. I have some toasted coconut milk. Usually I have soy milk too, but I ran out yesterday. And then in here, so these are some pre-cooked vegetables. So there's broccoli, squash, mushroom, and something else in there, I think. But I just prepped both of those so I can add them to any type of meal that I want to. Right here, I have some leftover crumbled up tofu to cook. And then in here is from leftovers from a burrito I had last night. So there's sweet potatoes, squash, corn, and some black beans in there. And there's also some pre-cooked rice right there. So I usually always have like pre-cooked rice, pre-cooked quinoa, anything like that, just to be able and throw in a bowl in here. Super, super helpful tip is just to cook it at the beginning of the week. Don't know why you're out of focus. And then right here, I have a bowl of pineapple. And then this is actually my leftover burrito that I had last night. I just didn't have any other bowl to put it into. So that's right there. Such a yummy recipe. Then I have a peach right here. I had another one, but already ate that as well. Like I said, I just really try to grab any fresh fruit that I can have. Then I have some mushrooms. And then this is some cilantro and some purple kale that I put in a cup of water. So I always recommend just grabbing any type of fruit you can and any type of veggies, just like mushrooms, anything like this, and just pre-cook them and have them in your fridge. That way you can throw them in meals and just provide more veggies throughout the day. And then I also just have some salsa right here. This is a really, really good brand right here. Super clean ingredients. It's from Fresh Cravings, so I definitely recommend that. Then this is some hummus that I have. This is the Cedars Organic. It's super, super good. So I just dip the carrots in the hummus and I really, really love this. I definitely recommend having hummus on hand. It's a really easy snack just to grab out of the fridge and have. This is an onion, nothing really special. And then this is some leftover squash that I cut up. So I haven't cooked that yet, but I just put that in there for whenever I want to cook it. And then this is some arugula. So I always, always have in some type of greens on hand. Last week I had a spring lettuce mix. And then the week before that I had regular kale. So just always have something like this so you can either make a salad or throw it into a bowl, throw it on top of whatever you want and just get in those greens again, like I was saying. On here in this bottom drawer, I have some Brussels sprouts that I actually really need to cook up. And then I have a purple cabbage. So you guys know I pretty much throw this on top of anything that I have. It just adds in so many antioxidants and gets in more veggies for the day. And then these are just some cherry tomato or cherry plums down here that I really actually need to throw away. Now on to the freezer aspect. So in here, I just have some frozen spinach that I throw into my smoothies. Back there is some frozen zucchini that was going bad, and I just freeze it and throw it into smoothies too. This is where frozen strawberries are supposed to be, but I'm out of those. And then I just have some frozen bananas right here, and then some Ezekiel bread in the back. Okay, so this is like my little cart that I just have over here with a couple different snacks. So up here, I just have some pre-made granola in the back. Will focus. So I actually do have a recipe for this in one of my videos, so I will tag that in the description box below. And then I have my superfood mixes right here. This is the Energy Bomb and Moon Balance. And then this is the Aura Trust Your Gut Powder. It's a pre and probiotic powder. I'll leave the discount codes for both of these products in the description box below if you want to check them out. And then I just have some Grow Macro Bars right here. So I do really prefer to always eat as many whole foods as possible, but I like to always have these on hand in case like I'm just in a hurry and I don't have time to make anything. Those are super, super good just to have. And then I have some peanut butter, of course. And then this is some hydrate that I throw in my coffee. It's just like an electrolyte powder, super good. It's salted caramel flavor, so I really, really like to have that.
Down here, I just have some rice cakes. Rice cakes and peanut butter and banana make the best snacks. And then these are also some crackers that I have on hand in case I'm just feeling a little bit snacky. So these are Mary's Gone Crackers, the Super Seed ones. They are super clean ingredients, so I really, really like that brand. And then back there, I just have some flax seeds that I always blend up. And then down here, I have some cashews that I make cheese sauces with. And then also some pistachios to snack on. And then those are just some teas back there in case I want to have some of that. So this is like our pantry that we have. So this is my rack up here. So these are kind of just like some essentials that I always keep on hand. Sorry that it's super, super dark. There's no light in here, but I just have a couple can of black beans. I like to make black bean burgers with these or throw them on any type of bowls, or last night I had burritos. And then I always have garbanzo beans just because I love to do like a sweet potato stuffed with chickpeas. It's a super good and super quick meal to have. And then right here I have some sunflower seeds and some cranberries. Dried cranberries. These are, once again, are just super good to throw on top of any type of meals. And back here, these are the soups that I've been loving. So these are the Amy's organic soups. They're super good if I just need a really quick meal or if I have too much studying to do. I'll just heat one of these up and eat some rice with it or something. And then I have some quinoa back here. And then these are some tuna packets and then some quinoa and brown rice. These are super yummy. I've showed them in a video before, so I really like having those just in case I don't have time to make rice. And then back here I have some whole grain pasta, and then I also have two things of black bean pasta. So these are super good and the macros on them are amazing. So they have 24 grams of protein, 23 grams of carbs, and 3 grams of fat. And the only ingredient in them is black beans. So I love having those on hand. And then this is just some rice that I'll make up usually. That's the rice that's actually in my fridge right now. And then I have some lentils if I want to cook those, some avocado oil, and then of course tahini to throw on top of anything. And then these are just some wraps that I have that I made burritos with. Okay, so I'm in Ashley's room now, and this is kind of where I keep all of my breakfast stuff just because I do usually eat breakfast over here, so I wanted to show you guys that. So I just have some quick cooking oats. I have oatmeal every single day for breakfast whenever I'm at school. It's just the easiest thing, and it's super yummy. Then I just have some more protein powder and vanilla flavor, some peanut butter to put on top of my oats. Then this is the greens powder that I use. It is also from Aura Organic, if I can show you guys. So this is their Easy Bean Green. Super, super good greens powder. I really like it and the ingredients. And then this is just what I put in the greens powder whenever I drink it. Then I also just have some tea back here, and then I have more tea right here, and then these are the superfood mixes that I have in here. So it's Mellow Yellow, and then also the Magic Mushroom, which makes like a healthy hot chocolate. Super, super good. And then in this drawer, I also have some Himalayan Pink Salt popcorn just to snack on in case I do get snacky at night or anything. In his fridge here, I don't have too much, but I do have some soy milk in here. And then these are some black raspberries that I eat in my oatmeal. This is some of the flaxseed that I have grounded up to also put in the oatmeal. Have some maple syrup and then some grapes that are almost gone. And then this is the creamer that I use in the morning if I don't make a latte in my room. And then in the freezer, I have some more frozen spinach and bananas in the back. More Ezekiel bread to eat with toast, and then also some frozen blueberries. Okay, so that is it for my pantry and fridge tour. I'm sorry if I went through that a little bit fast, but I didn't know like if I told you guys what everything was for or something, or if I held it up, if it would get too boring. I don't know, just let me know down in the comments below. Obviously I'm still trying to learn like what you guys like best, what type of videos and stuff. So if you liked the style of this video, then definitely let me know down below and give it a thumbs up. That way I know for sure. But yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and end this video here, but I hope that you got some good ideas of what you can keep in your pantry and fridge in order to stay healthy in college. It's super easy if you just make the effort. So definitely recommend just watching these videos and getting a lot of ideas as well. If you haven't subscribed already to my channel, please do. That way you can keep on getting a lot of healthy tips about living in college as well as just life in general. I hope that you like this video, and I'll see you in the next one.